here story for Warehouse. It's the after party with Stephen Michael Quesada. Featuring the James Douglas Show. Stephen's guests tonight are comedian Freddie Charles and special guest Vince Gilligan, creator and writer from Breaking Bad. And music by Shane Whalen. And now, the man with all the questions and all the answers, Stephen Michael Quesada.
Welcome, welcome. Thank you. Thanks.
Appreciate it. Yeah, you like that,
I
huh?
I like that. I like
it. Jumped the ice cream guy when he came by it.
I have no explanations for that. I don't.
He don't have an explanation. He can't even look at it. He's like, oh my God. He's like a little kid going, no, we can't go to the bathroom. We're in line for the game. Is mad.
I had to put my boxes on before my.
That is mean.
Wow.
See what women go through? Don't ever talk bad about women no more.
So, let me tell you a story about me and my brother. We went to the Albuquerque Wine Festival. You guys go to the Albuquerque Wine Festival, right? What you don't know is that for many, many years, my brother had this long, beautiful, dark hair and this really Mr. Cool goatee, right? He 6 foot tall, tough vato, right? Well, he got a promotion, right? And they made him cut his hair, and he shaved his thing to a mustache, right? So we're at the Albuquerque Wine Festival. I don't think this ever happened to my brother, right? This big guy comes up to him and goes, what's in that cooler? And my brother goes, what? He goes, what's in the cooler? My brother goes,
my wife's wine.
He goes, well, bust it out, man. My brother's like,
I can't. It's not my wine. Right?
The dude goes, well, are you afraid of your wife, man? My brother goes,
yes. Never would you hear my brother talk that way, man. My brother, Mr. Tough, right? And then so then he goes, and when my wife gets here, she's going to beat the crap out of you. True story. So the guy walks away, and my brother looks at me and goes, I lost my mojo. Take me home. I don't even know if I have enough energy to walk to the car. You know? It's like Samson, right? They just whacked his strength from him. I just told him to grow it back. Right? Look at the guitar player. Yeah, dude. Yeah. It'll blow in the wind, you know? Thing is that, you know, and I don't like to talk bad, man, but he works for the church, right? It's for the archdiocese, right? And I go, why did you cut your hair, bro? Jesus has long hair. And if any job you can get in the whole world, that's the one you should be able to keep your hair. That's just my opinion. Thank you for coming to the after party. We have a killer, killer show for you tonight. Right? We got Vince Gilligan, the creator and the writer of Breaking Bad, in the house tonight. We got one of the funniest comedians. I love him to death. Freddie Charles is here tonight. So we'll be right back, right here at the after party. Come on, bye, baby.
Mexicana Tortilla Company, the taste of home. 306 Cole Southwest, downtown Albuquerque.
Chamisa Hills Golf and Country Club, located in Rio Rancho, New Mexico, where we have beautiful golf swimming, and tennis. Please visit us on the web. Check out their 27-hole golf course with beautiful views of the Sandia Mountain. Chamisa Hills Country Club specializes in weddings, banquets, and all events. Chamisa Hills Golf and Country Club.
Hey, wanna smoke?
Wanna smoke?
Wanna smoke?
Wanna smoke?
No, I wanna dance. I'll make this plane. Don't wanna smoke. I got a brain. You're a jerk.
Welcome back to the After Party. Yes. Thank you for hanging out with us. Not a big introduction is necessary. He's just funny. Ladies and gentlemen, Freddie Charles.
Well, Albuquerque, party town. I'll tell you how he discovered it. Yeah. Yeah. In Albuquerque, you could be at a red light, look in the car next to you, two guys would be smoking a bong. You know what I'm saying? Not a pipe or a joint, a full-on glass bong with water, passing it back and forth, and apparently they're on duty because the lights are on, the siren's going. It's a party town. So let me tell you this story. Before I lived here in Albuquerque, I love living here, by the way, it's great, you know. But before I lived here, about 12, 13 years ago, I was doing a gig here in town, a comedy gig, and I got invited to a party after the show. And I go to the party, and there's these cute girls smoking some weed. So, okay, I'm an adult. You know, I don't have any children. I'm not a parent. By the way, if I did have kids, I'd be a proud parent. You ever seen that bumper sticker, "My child made honor roll" at, like, Lincoln Junior High? In China, they got a bumper sticker that says, "My child made your child's clothing." But that's a different show. Anyway. So I'm at this party, and this cute girl smoking some weed. This is like 12, 13 years ago. A couple guys in the mix, cute girls. I figure I'll get, maybe make a little love connection. I get in there. The guy in the end hands me the joint. I'm like, "Thanks, Governor Johnson." I take a couple puffs. And what happens sometimes when you smoke marijuana is your mouth gets all dry. Now, I didn't realize it, but after about a few minutes of smoking that weed, my mouth got so dry that my lip kind of stuck up there like that, you know? I didn't know it. I'm trying to be cool with all the girls. I'm like, "Hey, you're cute. What's your name?" So about 20 minutes later, I don't really remember. My friends told me about 20 minutes later, my mouth was so dry that my entire lip just disappeared off my face. Totally gone. And now I'm being a jerk. I'm going up to everybody at the party going, "Party, dude! Woo! Party!" So later that night, I'm driving home alone because I'm a dork, and I'm on I-25. I'm doing like pie in the fast lane. I was going really slow, so I get pulled over, of course. Now, I look back now, and I realize when the cop got out of his car, he was trying to get his pants out of his butt, kind of a thing, you know? But I was so high, I thought he was dancing. So now I think I'm being pulled over by the village people. I see the dancing cop. I'm freaking out. I'm rehearsing YMCA in the car for the big show, you know? So I see him coming up the side mirror of my car, and I finally notice that my lip is like gone off my face, but it's too late because he's like right there at the window now. So I figure I'll just be nonchalant, and I'll lick it down as I'm talking to the cop. He won't notice a thing, right? Is there a problem, officer? What? Oh, my leg, I have RLS. Thank you. My leg, I have RLS, that's the restless leg syndrome. Oh, that smell, I have IBS, that's the irritable bowel syndrome. Oh, my lip, I have SLLS, that's the sudden lip loss syndrome. I can go, that's so nice of you, sir. Thank you so much. So I'm sitting in jail there in Albuquerque, and apparently I licked his face when I said thank you. He didn't like that very much. But it's nice living here, I gotta say. Is it still stuck up there? I can kind of feel it, is it? Look at it down. All right, steroids. Anyway. By the way, since I moved here, my Spanish has gotten much better. Just the other day, I learned that the word Linda is beautiful in Spanish. And then I saw a commercial for Linda Beaver, and I'm thinking, beautiful. How do you say vagina in Spanish? I'm not sure, but. All right, good night, everybody. Thank you very much. Woo! The Micho got him, man.
Hey, it's Stephen Michael Quesada from Breaking Bad and the After After Party, inviting you to join the first golf tournament for Les Men's and the After After Party at Chamisa Hills Golf Club on July 24th. Please join me and other local celebrities in raising money because we're creating work here in New Mexico. So we're reaching out to you to come reach to us so we can create work and have a little fun, and maybe, and just maybe, you might get a hole in one. Back to the After After Party. Yeah. All right. Come on. I don't even have to tell you who this guy is. Ladies and gentlemen, Vince Gilligan.
Great band.
Isn't that great?
You're awesome. You guys are awesome. Yeah.
And we have a bunch of people saying that. They sit down and they go, wow, that's a great band.
Yeah.
And they, everybody's excited that you're here, Vince. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys. Thank you very much.
Well, what they don't know is you're shooting two episodes at the same time, and you've been crazy busy.
Yes.
And, you know, we were trying to get you last time, and it was just, there's no way. You know, I did
I'm usually drunk by this time, so this is this worked out perfect. This worked just good.
We can manage that later as long as you're done for the day.
You're done for the day. Actually, we just finished our last. We're shooting a little second unit tonight. Mm-hmm. As we speak, our wonderful crew is working over on Central Avenue in front of Garcia's, that great Mexican restaurant.
Yeah.
And, good food there. We just ate over there.
Oh, really, yeah, it is. Yeah. It's good, yeah.
Real good place. And I finished up directing episode 12 and 13 yesterday. So, that was
premieres?
Premieres July 17th, I believe. Yes.
They've been waiting, right?
Thank you, guys. Sorry for the long wait.
Yeah, they've been waiting out there. You're like the nicest guy that I've met in a long time. You're just a super cool human being. Wow. And everybody wants to know, are you a psychotic in there or what, man? Right? That show is the most crazy. You think of stuff that is amazing, right? And the world knows it now.
Well, thank you. I have a lot of help. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Sometimes it's good to be able to, you get some crazy ideas in your head. It's constructive and good to let them out through something that pays the bills. It worked out well for me.
That's right.
So I'm not, pushing a baby carriage full of carts, empty cans down the street and, yelling at the moon or something,
Because
that could be. That could be me. But luckily, I learned to figure out a way to make money off of the crazy stuff.
Goes on now that you've created, and I know that, a little history of that, when you came up with this concept, it was kind of just you and a friend kind of rapping about, an idea.
Right? I was talking to a buddy of mine, a guy I went to school with, I've known for college, 25, going on 30 years, I guess. And he and I were talking about, he's a fellow writer, and you know him, Tom Schnauz, he's one of my writers on Breaking Bad. And he and I, about 2004, 2005, he's a good writer, too. Uh-huh. You should, he's funny. You know, next time he's out, you should get him on your show.
He's
very funny. But he and I were talking about what do we do next, because we were coming off of the X-Files, and we weren't sure, the jobs were kind of trickling, drying up. You know, the offers were had reached a trickle. And we weren't sure what job we were going to get next. So we're like, what do we do now? What do we do for a living? And he suggested buying an RV and driving around the Southwest and cooking crystal meth. And and I'm not kidding. He was...
That's
and as far as I know, he was joking, but he did say that, and lo and behold, you know, something right then this something snapped, and this character, I didn't have a name for then, who became Walter White, that guy right there, he kind of popped into my head, and the rest is, I still to this day, I want to pinch myself to say the rest is history, but because I can't believe the show's even on the air in the first place, because it's a hard sell, a show like this. But lo and behold, here we are four seasons later now. So,
You know, and I sit here, I get to smile, Vince, because, you know, I can't give away anything on season four, but I think I can say this safely. This Mexican's still alive. It is hard to be a Mexican on Breaking Bad, baby, because, you know, there's something crazy around the corner for you.
I have to say, this guy here, Steven, we did a scene, that was it, last week, 2 weeks ago? Mm-hmm. Did a scene, Steven just knocked it out of the park. But fun scene, you'll enjoy. Gomez really has a moment in episode 12. Our second to last episode of season four. And you did a great job, man. Yeah.
Thank
some
you,
fine
man.
Acting.
I appreciate it. But, you know, we're sitting there and thinking, so Dean's going, this is so crazy, because when I read it, I don't know if you remember my audition, because you asked me, did you read the script? And I go, twice. And I don't read twice, twice.
Yeah.
But I didn't know you had written it. I thought you were a producer or whatever. We weren't introduced at the audition.
Right.
I just came in, and I said, I don't know who wrote this. Whoever wrote this, this is so damn crazy, this might work. Right?
And there was a little office we had on Jefferson, over there by, not too far from the Balloon Museum, and that was our first production office.
That's
over
right.
There. The ceiling was kind of caving in a little, like the water damage and stuff.
Yeah, you were sitting there, and I didn't know you were, and then you go, well, thanks, I wrote it. And I went, okay, I just blew this audition. Man, my big mouth. And I remember, you know, at home, being at home, and my agent calling me, jumping up and down, because they knew that Gomez was more than just what Gomez was going to be at the beginning.
Right.
That there was a good chance that Gomez was, you know, and Gomez is still here.
Gomez still here.
Yeah. So they were right. Everybody was right.
Yeah.
Everybody was right.
Well, that's a credit to you too, because you know, if you don't, as you were saying a minute ago, if you don't rise to the occasion when the opportunity knocks, you know. People die all the time on Breaking Bad, so.
I know, and in bad ways, right? Next thing you know, you're like a Chicano milkshake, you know, in that show. Like, how do they do that, you know?
I remember a story about, I can't remember what show it was, but one of those big shows where the, and this would never happen with us, but the showrunner was so fed up with a certain actor. I don't know what show it was. It was something like Hill Street Blues or something. It was a long time ago. But the guy ran the thing was so fed up with the actor that not only did he kill off his character, but he had half the episode take place at the guy's funeral, so that the actor had to lie in a casket for days on end playing a dead body.
Playing a dead body.
Yeah.
Because I tell my students that. Be good to people. Be nice to people. Don't treat people badly. I go, because check this out. This is what they could do to me. Two scenes. Close-up. Hands. Right? Yeah. And it's Gomez cleaning his gun. Gun goes off. Cut to funeral. Closed casket.
Closed casket.
Hank crying. And I go, and which one of those scenes was I in? I go, none of them.
Yeah. a lot of tricks in the
oh, yeah, they can get rid of you quick. No, it's easy to be on that show. You put together, like I have on this show, believe it or not, I have some of the greatest people on the show working on this
show. I can tell.
And I learned that from you, right? Because if you can surround yourself with positive, great people, it shows in the work. Because everybody knows it shows in Breaking Bad.
Oh, thank you, man. Appreciate it. Thank you, brother.
Vince, thank you so much for doing my show. I know you're a busy man.
Oh, thank you, Steven.
You know, and once again, July 17th, the first episode of season 4. Yeah. Please tune in. Please watch it. Thank you very much. We'll be right back on the After Party.
Thank you, guys.
Wait a minute. Your bass won't be back there. Oh, he heard me that time. All right now, I think he's ready. Huh. All right now, Mike C. You got some keyboards, won't be back there?
I got you, man.
Come on, Mike. Three.
Chamisa Hills Golf and Country Club, located in Rio Rancho, New Mexico, where we have beautiful golf, swimming, and tennis. Please visit us on the web. Check out their 27-hole golf course with beautiful views of the Sandia Mountain. Chamisa Hills Country Club specializes in weddings, banquets, and all events. Chamisa Hills Golf and Country Club.
Wanna smoke?
You like sucking coffin nails, but that's not the way I lead. I'd rather keep my youthful glow than wrinkles at 19. This is my goal. Don't you get it? Show it my goal. Get it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shane Wallen. Let's talk for a little bit real quick. Where can we get your music? Where can we hear it?
You can find it on ShaneWallinMusic.com, which is W-A-L-L-I-N, music.com, Shane Wallin Music.
Do you do like iTunes or any of that?
Yeah, you can actually find it on iTunes too. You can just look up my name, Shane Wallin, and I have a couple of CDs up there. My most recent's about a year old.
Yeah, okay. So, you know, we were really excited to have you on the show, and I didn't really, you know, announce it because I want everybody to hear your music, because now everybody knows how talented you are, man, and what a good sound you have, right? Where can we hear you live?
I actually play at the Chemo Theater on Thursday night, if anybody would like to come out there. We start at 7:30. I'm headlining a gig there, so.
Okay.
Play with another band called Little Sister.
Okay, all right. So. Right on. Dude, you're awesome, man. I love your music. Thank you so much for doing my show.
No problem.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you for hanging out with us on the After After Party. We'll see you next week. Orale. We'll see you.
Thanks, man. That was awesome. That was awesome. Thank you.
If I can over you, I'll be a new man.
There you go.
Not just another aimless guy with helpless alibis. I'll be a true man. I'll pour the water on the fire, find my way through the mire when no one's looking. And when the hits the fan, I'll have enough nerve to know what's cooking. 'Cause you just don't wanna let me go. You think I might fly, but I have no more sugar to go with all your spice. And I'm a simple man who wants a heart of gold, but you just can't play nice.